We talked yesterday about overcoming resistance. We talked yesterday about how you need to learn to overcome spiritual resistance so you can achieve what you want to achieve above your support level. And I said everything in life, whether it's financial, business, terms, or market, or health, or life, they have resistance and support. It's the principle of life. Childbearing, there's resistance and support. I mean, when a woman wants to give birth, she begins to shout and begin to curse and swear all kinds of things about the same person I said, I love. Hello. Because at that minute, he said, get out. I don't want to see you. I don't. Hey. But when the baby is out, the Bible says she becomes so happy. And that's the man she's looking for. I love you. Like, why? Because that was her resistance for the next level. Because her life mattered at that point. She could die. And the baby could die. See, everything about her life is this that need of death. And after that, rhythm is broken. She's not going to concern. No, this child, I've had a child. Now we're going to continue. Listen carefully. Likewise, in your life, you must overcome a spirit. I have that spirit. It's fighting me. It's fighting you. It's worrying over you. Even Jesus had to overcome it. In Jesus' case, it came over Peter. Peter said, you will not die. Peter said, you will not die. No. Why should you die? Peter says, why do you say you're going to die? It was Jesus says, get the red
recording started.
Jesus said, get them, you Satan. You don't have any interest of things of God. You have the interest. Understand that word. That's what I'm bringing from. You have the concern of the things of men rather than the things of God. Jesus told Peter, he said, Satan, get behind me. Satan, your interest is over for the things of men, never for the things of God. At the Garden of Eden, the same principle, Satan, you're always interested over the things of men, never the things of God. You don't put God priority, you put men priority. How to please the men you want to destroy, how to please people you like to be with, more than pleasing God. So even if they are leading you astray against God's will, you will not fight it. You will prefer their friendship rather than being a child of God. You rather the canopy, the reward of men, than the reward of God. There's a problem when that becomes your motto in life.
My God.
Write it down. The interest of men, and that's on that series. The interest, thank you, Secretary General. Hallelujah. Wow, and mommy. Praise God.
Now, the interest of men.
Rather than the interest of God. Satan's tool. But let me go back to the train we are riding this morning, lest I miss the takeoff point. Thank you, Holy Father. We welcome you this morning. Holy Spirit, we surrender. We yield our lives to you. Speak to us, yes, minister Lord. To us. Make the word so simple, but yet effective and powerful. Make it so clarity and encouraging that we'll be Holy motivated Spirit. And we'll see clearly.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Like I said, don't be in a hurry to exit the ministry today because we're going to pray more. You've experienced what I'm not about to share. Every one of you have experienced it. But that there are certain people in your life, they know what you ought to do. They know that you have potentials. They know that you have destiny. They know that you can make things happen. But when it comes for them to help you sometimes, it becomes a problem. Hello. In fact, they will join with the enemy to rattle you anytime.
That's right. My God.
They are your friends. They love you. Some of them can be in your house. Some of them don't get you. They love you. But when it comes to loyalty, it's not on your side. Their loyalty is not to you.
That's right. My God.
I mean, how many people tell me LOL since I started this almost 6 years ago? Oh, we love you. We appreciate you and that. But the day they saw me do something else, that was going to be a blessing. It took offense. Since that day, and the friendship stopped. But when there's problem, they will look for a number. I had your number somewhere. Oh, Pastor, I have no job for why? Please, hey. I called him. I said, Akwaracha must come back. When we're growing up, the principle I learned as a child, I try not to offend you. But I mean, if I've not offended you and you choose to leave me in my place of need, because I know what I have, you always come back. I had a pastor in Nigeria when we were growing up in the Assemblies of God Church. As a young guy, he said, Akwaracha, because when we were growing up, there's these people that come to pick bottles, recycling. They will have a big button and a small button, they'll be hitting it together. Mostly Eastern traders. That was their in the early 70s and maybe mid 80s. Early 70s, and I think they were in 70s. They'll be hitting the button together. They will pass your street, meaning all the medication bottle you bought will want it back. And they'll price your bottle for you. So recycling is not new. They've been doing it.
Mm-hmm.
And they'll take the same bottle, flush it, and put medication and resell it. The guy may not come this month. He may not come 6 months time. I mean, 3 months time. But the guy will always come back.
Mm-hmm.
Say, madam, do you have any empty bottles? Because he knows you finish all the medication. Here. And my mom will always keep the bottles for these guys. There's a spirit called the spirit of Abner.
Mm-hmm.
It always comes back. It always make a check on you. Now, before I say, who is Abner? You go, what is he? Abner. Abner is a name of a person in the Bible.
Mm.
In fact, that guy's name appears 52 times in the Bible.
Mm.
But the principle there, so that guy's name appeared more than Satan's name in the Bible. That's what I'm trying to tell you now.
Mm.
Satan's name did not appear almost 30 times. You can't find the word Satan in the Bible like that. But that guy's name appeared more than him.
Mm.
Or similar. The reason I'm explaining this to you, when Bible talks about Jezebel, Jezebel appeared so many times in the Bible, and Balaam, but in the book of Deuteronomy, he still mentioned this boy's name. You thought they were dead, but as long as the spiritual is concerned, it's a spiritual thing. The spirit still manipulating the earth.
That's right.
Likewise, the spirit of Abner is a spiritual being.
Mm.
There are people like that. So when you talk about Apostle William, or Pastor Felicia, you find that there are people that look like us. They have the same character. That's why you can read somebody and say, ah, you resemble, you look like, you just like somebody I know. You are like that. Although there's some intricate differences, but it's not that overwhelming. Abner is an individual in the Bible that you must be afraid of. They surround you. They appreciate you. Sometimes they love you. Sometimes they say, oh, we love you so much. But the basis of that love is not substantial.
Mm.
They want to be with you when you are breaking and moving on. But the minute your opponent takes off, they leave you and support your opponent.
My God.
When you cannot break above certain resistance, they are impatient to wait for God to move you on. Did you get that? When you cannot break above certain resistance, they are impatient for God to move you on. When you cannot break up to certain resistance, they choose not to wait for you and God to do what God wants to do in your life. Their loyalty is very questionable. Their commitment is very questionable. I pray God to give us loyal people.
Mm-hmm.
People whose loyalty, you can't question, people whose commitment is genuine, people whose attitude is a reality.
Mm-hmm.
I pray God for you as well, that you have such people in your life. People who are committed to God, who are committed to the things of God, who are committed to life itself and to your future. The spirit of Abner, let's go to the Bible and discover who this man is. The Bible says, 1 Samuel chapter 14, verse 50. He says, his wife's name was Abner, daughter of Hamaza. The name of the commander of Saul's army was Abner, son of Ner. You want to know that man? Ner. And Ner was Saul's uncle. Abner was Saul's cousin. Loyalty in biblical time is tied to family line. People that fight for you, most people related to you.
Right.
People that will die for you because it's a family enterprise.
Hmm.
So if you're a king from Benjamin, you want to take people from Benjamin, put them in king position because it's for the welfare of everybody there.
That's
fine. Abner and Saul grew up together. Similar age mate. The Bible says that In verse 51, Saul's fathers, Kish and Abner's father, Ner, were sons of Eber. So Kish and Abner's father, Ner, are the same father.
Mm-hmm.
So they are related. But understand something about Abner. Is that Abner and like his father, Ner, are dangerous people.
Mm-hmm.
When Samuel gave a prophetic word to Saul, he said, see that you don't tell anybody. When Saul was coming, his uncle, Ner, was the first person that went to meet Saul and took Saul aside.
Mm-hmm.
So what did Samuel say to you?
Hmm.
What did Samuel say to you?
Hmm.
Then Saul said, he said the sheep be found, but Ner did not believe him. He let him go. But that was it. Why would Ner, understand, why would he be interested about another man's destiny?
That's right. My God. Hmm.
Because if Saul had told Ner that he was going to be king, Saul would have been dead.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, let me tell you something. Not everything you do, you tell some family members what you are doing, or you tell people what you are doing.
That's right.
If they are not with you, if you have not tested their heart,
mm-hmm.
to see whether their heart is with you.
That's right.
I said, as a ministry, we are all children of God. I've made a couple of mistakes. But some of the mistakes I made was last year convention when I showed the vision of mm-hmm. the prayer city.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, the place was packed.
Mm-hmm.
Not this year convention, 2009
That's right.
convention, July.
Mm-hmm.
The place was packed. Other people from Dallas, the original partners, they heard what was going on. They came. Everything was booming. And so if you remember, the architect showed that drawing of the prayer city. The three architects, the three white men, they came out and spoke to the people. Boy. Oh, come and look what the spirit of Abner did.
Mm-hmm.
Thank God for God protecting us. If we were not full of prayer,
right.
we would have even run away ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm talking about?
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm. After that meeting,
that's right.
Every church in Dallas, most of the churches in Dallas, they even told their people not to join the prayer line. They all began to start prayer line. The same time, they began to monitor those in prayer line. They began to look for those. It was like a warfare. Wawen was shaking to the core. You know what I'm talking about?
Oh, yes.
Wawen was shaking to the core. There was a fallout in Wawen. Even those partners that you thought, this one we've labored with you this far, this level.
Mm.
You can't leave us this level.
Mm.
They all turned their backs. They're saying, this is what this man wants to do. But thank God that when
thank
God gives
you
a word,
that's right. Ooh.
That's what I want to tell you. Resistance will come.
That's right.
Abundance will come. But if you know that God is faithful,
that's right.
That what He says He will do,
Messiah,
that's what He will do.
Yes, Lord.
There was a time last year we could not even pay the mortgage on the land because there was only bank. It was personal financing with the owner. I thought we were giving over $100,000 down payment, $100,000 on top of that. That we only like 4 months. The man now called and says, you are a man of God. God told me, white man said, God said you are the one to get this land, and this land is yours. Don't be worried. Take time to pay. You remember?
Oh yes.
We went to drove. We drove to go look for his wife in the hospital. His wife pains in the hospital in Denton. He said, Pastor, you're a good man. This thing, the old man that gave the fact the son-in-law of the land was telling me. So I knew God spoke to me. The church is gonna come that will live to see it.
Oh yes.
Said, don't. That was last year. Boy, it was rough. Because when Abner hit hard, it hits hard.
That's right.
But you must overcome resistance. That was last year. I mean, we don't owe him anything. Amen. God is faithful. We want to thank you all. Thank God for all of you that are still with us.
That's
for your faithful. You made it happen.
Oh, yes.
God and you made it right. Thank God for your lives. So we're not owing. We're up to date. Now, what am I saying is, if you think in life, you just accomplish things easily. It's a lie. You've deceived yourself.
Oh, yes.
If you think things will just go easy because you are sharp, smart, bright, Somebody say Abba.
Abba.
Abba means father. Abner. You find that Abner, because Saul became king, Saul has to put his cousin, his father's brother's son, as his commander. Now understand that Abners are quick to attract promotion. They are discoverers. They are foresight. If Abners were good people, Abners are quick to discover promotion or a trend. Some of you on this line, it is Abners that gave you the number. You didn't discover this, but somebody gave it to you, and the person that gave it to you doesn't even pray anymore.
That's right.
Okay. Hello, somebody hear what I'm saying this morning? The person that introduced to the prayer line, they don't even pray anymore. But you are still praying. Others are quick to recognize a trend. They are quick to pick up. They have foresight like this, their father and men. They see what you are doing. They can ask you, what are you doing? Something good is about to happen to you, but they will not celebrate it with you.
That's right. My Lord.
Because Abner is a deal maker. Abner must secure his own portion as long as it takes before he puts your interest before him. May you not marry a husband or a wife that is an Abner. Oh, Jesus. Somebody pray with me. Say, Father, deliver me.
Deliver
from household Abner spirit. Somebody pray for continue.
Father,
deliver me from household Abner spirit.
Deliver me from Abner household spirit of God. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord.
In Christ Jesus' name we pray. Amen. There's so much teaching. There's so much teaching. Let's flow. We'll pray. Listen. It is Abner's spirit and those kind men you labor with. By the time you are getting old, they will take off from you.
My God.
It means they've used you. They don't see your star rising anymore. So they want to go and hunt again. The same man or woman that discourage you from pursuing your career, that have so many reasons why you should not do what you are doing, that frustrated you to make sure you quit. Abner, because he's afraid. He's afraid that if you go too far, so he'd rather deny you and suffer with you temporarily, but know that you're supposed to go far, than allow you to be the leader, to allow you to take the lead. It's a challenge. They can't stand it. That relative, that cousin, that brother, that sister, that sees you as a threat of celebrating you as a blessing, but sees you as a dangerous threat to their progress. Abner's spirit is that pastor friend that pastors you only for a reason. Hello, man of God, what are you doing now? What are you up to now? I find that I was surrounded by so many ministers who are Abner's. The reason they loved me was because of what God was doing in my life. The reason they were my friends was because God was lifting me higher. The minute I came to resistance, they all disappeared of my life. Then I discovered that sometimes in life, God wants you to hide yourself.
That's right.
Hide yourself. Until he finishes what he's doing.
That's right.
No wonder Jesus will heal people. He will say, don't say it out. He will say, don't let nobody know I healed you. But they want this. He say, I don't want resistance now. Don't say it. Just go home. They will not agree. I myself, I'll say, Jesus, why are you doing like this? Even Jesus' brothers told him, if you want to be famous, you don't stay home. You go to where the action is. Jesus says, you seek the desire of men. I'm not like you. Tomorrow we shall discuss those ones. Remind me next week. Remind me. Let me not forget that one about Jesus and his sibling. Because you know Jesus had brothers and sisters. He was arch rivals. The Bible says even his own sibling did not believe him. You don't understand the principle of Abner, right? You get it. Is somebody hear what I'm saying this morning? Can I preach on this morning? Can I talk to you? Glory to God. We praise Jesus. Father, we give you praise.
Thank you
for who you are. To you belong all the glory,
yes,
and
Lord.
All the praise and all the admission. Your glory no man will take. We humble ourselves to you. We
Lord.
Thank you this
thank
morning.
You, Father, Lord.
This is when you wake up somebody you love. I say, listen to this, dear. Even if it's your spouse, say, wake up. I know you don't like, but listen, you may get angry. Be honest, you may get angry with this teaching this morning, but listen. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
So there's clarity of air. And they will think you report them to me, basically. Believe me. I've seen it before. I was preaching. Somebody says, everything I do, you come and preach it. I said, when did you talk? He said, everything I do, if I do you, he said, so I'm angry. He said, you remember? I said, what? He said, because everything I do, without me telling you, God tells you what I'm doing. So I'm scared. I said, don't be scared. It means you have to repent.
That's right.
When the prophetic anointing, when the prophetic anointing comes, you can see things ahead of time. May your eyes be on the prophetic anointing
in
by the Holy
name
Spirit.
Of Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Jesus. Abner. Spirit of Abner. It's everywhere. Now, it's interesting to know that Abner was with David. And Abner went to war with David. I mean, with Saul, I mean, not with David, with Saul. When Saul and every Israelite, including Abner, ran from Goliath. Abner was the one that brought David to Saul. Listen, in 1 Samuel 17:15, as Saul watched David going out to meet the Philistine, he said to Abner, because David went to servants and asked, and the woman went to the commander, and
That's
Abner
right.
is the commander.
That's right.
He asked, said to Abner, commander of the army, Abner, whose son is that young man? Abner replied, as your surely as you live, your majesty, I don't know. So Abner wanted to inquire, who is this young man you brought to me? As soon as David returned from killing the Philistine, Abner took him. Now David is a star. Nobody is there. No. He wants to be the kingmaker. He wants to, so that David will always know that, don't forget, I can enjoy your glory now.
That's right. Quick to discover promotion.
Quick to discover. Abner knew that David is about to become a star. People like Abner, they make millions from entertainment. They see a superstar footballer when you see a song that is just big and wasted. That's what they call agency. Booking agency is operated by the spirit of Abner. As long as you're a star, you are good. When you're a non-guy star, they kick you out. They don't have no time to do with you. There's no love. The reason they attract to you, if you watch the movie The Blind Side, thank God for that woman. She was always kicking them out. Abner, they will come and say, hey, yeah, you are going somewhere. Let me attach to you. Can I borrow you some money right now? I need to watch it. They'll loan you money. They say, take money. Take money. There's a paper right now of one guy at the University of Duke, in the Auburn University. He's supposed to be Milton's name. He's a college football player. He's a black young guy. Brilliant star in quarterback in football. He's going to, they said he might be the Heisman Trophy winner. But already, the news is already scandalizing his father and his family. He said because he took bribe 3 years ago. What bribe? Abner's came. Your son is going to be a star. Let's give you some money. Buy food for home. Like Reggie, what the guy from New Orleans. These people are poor black people. They are struggling. They start, the father wants to make sure he has a pay. They will need money. But the Abner's, if that child becomes a star, they will blackmail you to pay more. Hello.
Hi, Lord.
Hello. Free gifts from an unbeliever. Free gifts from a man whose heart is not clean.
That's right.
You will vomit it out. Proverbs, Solomon tells us, because Solomon discovered this. He said, do not go to a table of a man that is greedy. When the person is not a giver, and he also then invites you, say, come and eat. Come. In the Proverbs. He says, because you will vomit everything you've eaten. By the time that guy is done with you, every food you swallowed, you vomit it out. It's in Proverbs. You remember? So when the table is set before you, that's my battle. Let me look for it. I want to share something with you this morning. I want your life to be blessed. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, come and join me, sing hallelujah. Jehovah Jireh has done me well. Da da dan 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 dan. Come and join me, sing hallelujah. Jehovah Nissi has done me well. Hallelujah. Come and join me, sing hallelujah. Oh yes, Jehovah Jireh has done me well. Hallelujah. Come and join me. He has opened my eyes to revelation. Jehovah Jireh has done me well. I want to look at that scripture for you, because this, the word of God is flying in my mind. I just want to make sure you have it. It says, when the table is set before you, be careful how you eat it.
Mm.
Now, it's not talking about Christians. Don't get me wrong.
Mm-mm.
Not talking about somebody you love, somebody that know you, you know. It's talking about people that they just hear of you. You're a superstar. They invite you. They have their own agenda. The reason they are your friends is because of what you can offer them.
Oh.
Though you are low and small, they believe you have something for them to enjoy. They believe that there's a talent in you.
Mm.
They come to you. They rush to you. When the brothers or the sisters saw you, say, this man is going somewhere. If I'm too weak, this man will help me. This guy is too talented. I won't let him go. Ah! You thought she was in love. It's not in love. It was in interest. Talks about it. Says, put a knife in your throat when you go and sit before a ruler. Put a knife. Hallelujah, somebody. Libro, pray with me. Pray for a while. Just pray. Calabro, Kazote, Brikondo. Say, Lord, every hunter of Abner, everyone that Abner has employed to hunt my life, Mazokande. Pray,
everyone
that has been on contract to discover me for Abner. Hide me. Hide me. As you are praying, go to Proverbs 23, verse 2. Proverbs 23 verse 2. While you are praying, may proceed. Hide me, oh God. Hide me. Hide me. Hide my name. Something has happened.
God.
That I've hidden myself. People are worried. Where is he? They are thinking all kinds of stuff.
Father, hide me.
Where is Lord. Apostle William? We don't hear. The Lord told me, your star was shining too bright. I got to hide your head. They will just destroy you. He told me that yesterday. The Lord was telling me. I said, Lord, I've been separating myself from everybody, just running from everybody. That's wrong. I'm hiding you, because by the time I lift you up, you now know. You now know who is secretary will stay in the front, and you're not sure.
That's right.
And who wants to come and see me be busy? Hello. It's a principle. Proverbs 23, verse 7. It says, let me read from verse 6. Amplified Bible. Eat not the bread of him.
That's right.
Who has a hard, grudging, and envious eye. See, Abner is a spirit of envy.
That's right.
I just gave him a name so you can identify with him. The root word for Abner is a spirit of envy. I never knew I have an envious spirit one time. Until I find that when we talk about city people, I get oppressed, I get angry. I never knew I had envious spirit. Oh, you are shocked? Oh, I know you are a saint. Thank God God has forgiven me and cleansed me. I used to be an envy person. If I hear anything good, I know you never had that spirit. If I hear anything good happening, I say, why not me? I'll go to God and get depressed. Oh God, I've been serving you. Why not me? God says, are you normal? I said, what do you mean, Father? Why not me? Why not me? God says, I cannot deal with you in this spirit. It's not part of my nature. And God began to break it in me. I began to cry, don't take it away. Leave me a little bit. God says, no. I can't anoint you. The way I want to anoint you, this spirit will destroy you. And God healed me and delivered me. That's how you see, I'm surrounded with good people. Wow, things are going well in all my life lately.
Thank you.
Because you don't know you have it until you go through the valley. So pray, every spirit of envy in me.
Every spirit of envy, oh God.
I resist you.
I reject you.
I rebuke you.
I refuse you. I refuse you right now. Get out of my life in the name of Jesus Christ.
Get out of my life. I
get out of my life.
You don't know you have it. It's there. It's there. It's there.
In the name of Jesus.
That makes you say, I pray. I don't get any result. It's that spirit. That's how the spirit talks. I prayed. Why is God passing me by? As nothing is happening to me, my situation is not changing. It's envy. It's because you are looking at other people. You are seeing their situation change. So you are not angry that you have to say my situation is not changing. It's an you have it, my dear. You don't have anyone. No, you have it. That's it. It's there. You cry to God.
Say,
God, deliver me. Deliver my heart to the Holy Spirit. Deliver my marriage from envy.
Deliver
my life from envy.
Deliver us, oh God. Deliver me, Lord God, in the name of Jesus Christ, my household. Who shall go back and Santaya, Father, Lord God? Deliver our family.
Your brothers have it. All your siblings have it. Maybe one or two that will not have it. From childhood, they argue with you. Anything you have, they want to get it. You buy this car, your brother must buy the other one. It seems you are competing. Hello? You know what I'm saying? Isn't you and your siblings? It's a competition. You have three children, they will have three or four. Nobody wants to have. No, everybody seems to be competing because it's your culture, it's the way they grow us up. Hello? When you were young, your father would say, don't you see your brother is better than you? Abner Smith just entered you right there. Even your father practiced it. The child that is doing well, that's the one he's interested in. Can I talk about your father's house a little bit? Can I expose your father's house? The one that is doing well, that's what he celebrate. So that one begins to prove himself to do more well. So if he wants to remain that position, not knowing that the young shall grow, all of a sudden the one that they said he do well, now she breaks somewhere. Then the one you not begin to shy. Then that one gets angry. Why is it you now? Because they pampered him already or her. Absolutely, you are taking off. I can't take it. He goes into awkward, begins to look for your star. Why is that my brother and sister doing well? I can't stand it. No. Because even your father practiced it. Your father is ogone. He wants to know what has God said he wants to do with your life. Hello.
Hi.
It's a principality that rules government. It rules nations. What is your country having right to go invade on that country if not for the gold and the mineral and the oil? Hello, Abner. How can an island want to colonize the whole world? Hello,
hi.
Abner. Say, spirit. Then he's not satisfied with what he has. He must go out there to go take what others have.
That's right.
It's a deep teaching, my dear. Really.
I love.
Victory over the spirit of Abner. It operates at your place of work. It operates at your place of work right now. It operates in the city you live in right now. It operates in the church you go to right now. It operates in the roof you... Hey, Jesus. When was the last time you and your wife or your spouse... Yeah, you got to be your wife, right? You just to be a woman. Oh. All right. We don't support those other ones. We got a person who uses. When was the last time you and your wife had a plan and you stuck with that plan for good? It's going to benefit both of you equally. It's not going to benefit one person better. The last time you have a plan, you said, we're doing this together for our family. We stick with it. Help me, I help you. And you did not turn around and send some. If you send money to your family behind your wife's back without telling your wife, you're operating the spirit of Abner.
That's right.
Oh, did that just break your heart?
Yes.
Do I tell you if I send money to strangers?
Yes.
Do I really tell you? Even if somebody not my family, and I want to send, don't I call you and say, this person was good to me. I'm going to send this.
That's
fine. I'll say, I need you to help me. Okay. Do I?
You
do. No, for you, it's behind. Your husband don't know what you do. You are like a secret society in the house. You are a, not FBI, you are a YBI or CAC. Wife CIA or husband BI. I mean, you are so secret. When she's coming, you chop some paper under so he or she doesn't see it. Hello? And you pretend. Abner. Oh, I just broke your heart. Thank God, God is delivering you from wickedness.
That's right.
My because God. Before you pray for that person to die, you got to make sure that you're not praying that you kill yourself. Hello? Remember, I just tell you that. I said, before you, anytime you pray about witchcraft, I said, make sure your life is clean because when you start praying, you start from you first. Before you say, oh, fall and die, let fire destroy. I hope it's not, you're not setting yourself on fire. Very, very important, you know, before you pray certain prayer points, you yourself, you're clean. He says, the wicked one comes and found nothing in me. Jesus says, the wicked one must come to check us out.
Mm.
Oh, you're a pastor. You think you are all that. All right. The wicked one is going to come to filter you. He told Simon, he said, Simon, Satan had just put a request to sift you. Simon didn't understand what he was. Simon said, what are you talking about, Jesus? I don't know what you're talking about. Satan sift me for what? He says, but I have prayed for you. Say, Lord, pray for me.
Lord, pray for
me. Ask my Father, you, Jesus. Jesus. Say, Jesus, you need to intercede. The Bible says in Hebrews, He needs to intercede for you. Say, Lord, intercede for me. Come by me. If you don't have a problem, pray for me and my wife. Lord, intercede for someone that loves me. Intercede for the she that does. Intercede for one of somebody pray with me this morning. I want someone to cry with me. Intercede for me, Jesus. Intercede for my family. Intercede for my sibling.
Intercede for this family, Christ Jesus. Lord,
intercede for me.
For
the wicked one comes. And you don't want to come and find anything in me. Intercede for me, my Lord and my Lord. Intercede for me, my kingdom, my soul. Intercede. Let this kingdom be broken off my life.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ. I told you today you are not in a hurry. Don't be in a hurry. Today is a good day. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Today is the day that God came and visited us.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Ooh, Shabbat Shalom. Beat you over the spirit of Abner. You are in one roof, but you are a secret organization of your own. Maybe there's a just reason. Because that person, whenever he knows anything good, he must destroy it. Hello, because there's people like that. When you tell them, oh, there's something here, if they don't have it ruined, they will not rest. They'll begin to trouble you. That thing you have, they bring it. Bring it. It's like the spirit of Sodom. We want to sleep with that man. Lord, bring them out. If that is not destroyed, they don't rest. That's the spirit of Abner. No, the spirit of Sodom. If it does not exhaust that thing, it can't rest. Until that thing is done. So in that case, run for your life. Take cover. Hello.
Hi.
You can keep your secret now because if you share them out, that thing must be ruined. There's people like that. Pastor, what will I do? Pray. Paraventure. Because that's how they have been raised. There's no deliverance. You can't help them. You can't change that situation.
That's right.
Talking will not do it. Proverbs 23. It will be bread of him who has a hard, grungy, and envious eyes. Whoa. So some eyes are hard. Neither desire is dainty foods or dainty foods, for as he think in his heart, so is he. It's a principle for everything. Don't be successful as you think. That's how you are. That's where that principle came from. You see, this Abner, they manifest their thought.
That's right. Yeah.
They manifest their heart is what their action is. Their heart.
That's right.
They can't fake it. It's just that you are not discerning it. You are not seeing it. They show, they manifest it. Any little thing you see, they manifest it already. But you may not see it.
That's right.
Because you are caught up in another deception. Say, Lord, open my eyes to see Abner in my life. Say, open my eyes to see Abner in my life. And give me the wisdom to know how to relate and deal with Abner. For some of you are so much deep in, you are in Abner's hand.
That's right.
Tell them when you're in love. Oh Lord, I caused some foolish love. But it's too late now. You can't go out of it now. Except something else otherwise. Amen. You know my stand in such issue. Except there's violence, beating or adulterous relationship, then you can go out. That's what the Bible says, then you can exit it. But if those things are not there, sorry. Hello.
Hi.
Oh, you are in love, then pray. Still pray, Lord. Let God do something for you. What am I saying? What am I saying? We're done. He says, as one who reckons, keeps a record. Abner keeps record. They are good bookkeepers. They know when they pick you, they know where you are going, and they can remind you what was said concerning you. Jesus help me. He says to you, eat and drink, yet his heart is not with you.
God.
Is not with you. Verse 7. But it's grudging the cost. It's calculating the cost of what you are doing. The cost is going to pay for the food you are eating. It's greedy. It's calculating something. His heart is not with you. He says, the muscle which you have eaten, you will vomit up. And your complimentary words will be wasted. You go, wow, is that in the Bible? Yes, it's in your Bible. Let's go back to where we are reading. I want to just make sure for you. Ah, Jehovah, the spirit of Abner. Ah, ya, kato, no pro kanta baso kando le pro kinda. First Samuel 17:57. As soon as David returned from killing the Philistine, Abner took him and brought him before Saul. And David, still holding the Philistine's head, this trophy. Ever since then, Abner like David. Saul like David. Jonathan like David. Now, understand something about Abner. In 1 Samuel 20:25, he says, he sat in his customary place by the wall, opposite Jonathan, and Abner sat to Saul. That's what I'm saying. Abner, they eat together. David has not joined the club. But you know, David now had a good friend, Jonathan. You need a Jonathan in your life.
That's right.
It's the antidote for Abner. The spirit of Jonathan is the antidote to Abner. Oh, God. Let me say something to you. Saul, before you got to that place in chapter 20, Saul now hated David. Why did Saul hate David? Because the women were now singing.
That's right.
That Saul has killed 1,000 and David has killed 10,000. That provoked Saul. That Saul told Abner, see what they are saying? They are praising this guy over me. So from that day, Saul had a hatred, envy. Spirit of Saul. Spirit of Saul and Abner, they're the same. They are cousins, don't forget. The same spirit. It's called the spirit of Saul. I'll talk about that more.
That's right.
But Abner is the same thing as Saul, but a different degree. Saul said, see, they're lifting this guy up. Saul took a hatred. He wanted to kill David so that his children, Jonathan and his dynasty, will be protected. See, the spirit of Saul kills while Abner does not kill. The spirit of Saul set to kill so that the children yet unborn can be protected wickedly and gone, so that you that God wants to elevate, your own descendant will be wiped out.
That's right.
Saul's angle is to kill him so that they will not be king, because Jonathan must be king and Jonathan and his dynasty must remain. So in witchcraft, the spirit of Saul seek to kill destinies. While Abner wants to befriend to betray destinies. Oh, Jesus.
My God.
I want us to pray. We'll continue this teaching tomorrow, but I want you to pray. Because there's something I want to say. You've heard too much right now. You follow me? There's so much coming. We've not started there. We started the introduction. We don't inside the teaching, it's just the introduction of the teaching. But we'll pray, and I'll put one more stop. You must understand the point here to my people of God this morning. That when Samuel prophesied and anointed David to be king, Abner was not there. Saul was not there. The only people there were David's brothers. David's brothers. Now, understand very well. When Samuel now confronted Saul and said, the kingdom has been taken from you, publicly, people with the Abner was there, the military soldiers was there, and has been given to someone else that will serve God. Instantly, David's own brother knew that David was the one. So, from David's brother, Saul knew. Now understand, David's own brother that was in Saul's army were the same one that revealed the secret that it was David that is going to be next. And of course, Saul has already knew that David is becoming popular. That David was definitely going to be next. That's when the problem started for David. And that's when Abner knew that David was going to be king for sure. But yet, Abner began to oppose David. Jesus. The spirit of Abner, when he walks in your life, is that spirit that knows what you need to do to help you succeed.
That's right.
But for one reason, because of fear and envy, will not want to help you. Because they say if they help you succeed, you'll be too famous.
That's right.
They will not have access to you. Somebody told me one time. You remember?
I know.
Said, we don't want the ministry to be big. I said, oh, my enemy has manifested. Said, Pastor, no, you remember, right? Said, we don't want the ministry to be big because the ministry is big. It will be difficult to reach you. I go, oh, Lord, this is my enemy in a woman's skin. Told me right in my face, not behind me. Said, no, we don't want the ministry to be big. The ministry is too big. I said, oh, they want to put me in their bag. God, deliver me from Abner.
Thank you, God.
Deliver me. I had to be crying, God, to deliver me. You are going to pray. You ever shared a dream of how big you want to become? And your spouse tell you, that is too big. I don't think you are able to do it. No encouragement that maybe you can. No. You're afraid. You ever told your husband you want to enlarge your business and the guy said, no, don't do that. Because the guy is thinking, if he means enlarge, you don't have time for me. And you become a big madam. People, you have so many staff, then many people are kept from prospering because the spirit of Abner is working within their spouse or their house. So that every promise they pray, that spirit go to witchcraft and cancel it. Says, please don't make him rise too much. He said, if he rise too much, he will not have time for us anymore. You are going to pray this morning. Everywhere the powers of happiness have handicapped your destiny. Hey, this is where you pray, this is where you really cry. Everywhere the powers of Abner has sat on your glory too long. I don't know how you're going to pray, but pray. You pray. You have enough information to pray. You pray.
My God.